is Bloomberg UTV.
This week on Tech Tree, we get our fingers on the soon-to-be-released Nokia N900. We land behind enemy lines with the biggest-selling action game of the year. And we have Facebook and Twitter pitted against each other in duel.
Why do I want to listen to your boring thoughts put onto a computer?
You're not listening to me. You're selling your stuff. You're making people laugh. That's what you're doing.
Hello and welcome to the brand new Tech Tree. I'm your new host, Alap, and I'm going to be getting you your weekly dose of tech. Now, to start off with, we have a device out here that lets you edit documents, watch movies, browse the internet, play games, and all sorts of stuff like that. But no, we're not talking about this laptop here. We're talking about this device. Meet the N900, Nokia's latest and most powerful mobile computer.
We have with us the N900, Nokia's successor to the N810 series of internet tablets and the first to have full phone functionality. It's a VoIP and 3G capable phone with a 5 megapixel camera and is intended for the always connected, social network savvy gadget enthusiast.
So this is a very powerful and feature-packed phone. But I think the most interesting part about it is the fact that it runs Maemo 5. It's the new operating system that Nokia is planning to use in all its future N-series devices. This is actually a tablet, an internet tablet, as I like to call it. The N770, N800, these were the ones before it. This is the N900. This is the first one that's actually going to be released in India. It has a touchscreen, obviously. It also has a slide-out QWERTY keypad, which is quite comfortable to type on. I've been using it for some time. It has a new home screen, which lets you see a lot of different things at the same time. It has three different home screens, actually, so you can just slide between them. You can have lots of widgets running. They show you, they're live updating, so you'll have a weather widget, you have Facebook and Twitter and all these things. They keep updating. This one has plenty of memory, and the OS is also pretty much tweaked to take care of multitasking. So it runs up to 20 windows, and you can switch between them easily, and it's still going to remain very smooth and fluid. Besides the default web browser that you have in the phone, you can also download and install Firefox Mobile. It's as powerful as the actual Firefox. You can run the full Gmail interface, you'll be able to use Google Docs completely. There's full Flash support. You can actually play Flash games and everything on this. Now, I don't want to call this an iPhone killer because there's at least four of them coming out every year now. But we're not done with this phone yet. So let's move on to Vishal, our resident techie, and see what his take on the N900 is.
Hey Alap, comparing the N900 to the iPhone is like comparing a supercomputer to a calculator. It can do some really, really amazing things. Having been using it for some time, I can give you a user's perspective. It's among the few phones where instant messaging, VoIP, and social media is integrated as part of your phone. Think about it, you're making a call and you decide that, oh, this is an international call and I want to use Skype out. All you have to do is go to your dial pad, change one option. If you are using communication, so SMS and instant messaging is one. So you could be communicating on the same box, sending an SMS, and the same box receives instant messages. But that's really cool. Having talked about all this, I must tell you that this phone rocks when it comes to graphics. The 800 by 480 resolution screen with hardware acceleration makes it a very, very good gaming device. So if you look at some of the games here, especially Bounce, which comes preloaded with the phone, has some very, very amazing graphics and a complete accelerometer support where you're playing this game pretty much very, very smoothly. Having played with this, having used this phone, all I can say is I just now need a docking station and I can replace my laptop with the N900.
All right, Vishal, we'll get you a docking station for your N900. Now, this is actually a pre-ordered piece. It's not available in India yet, but we're expecting it sometime next year. The US and the European prices are roughly around 30,000 bucks, but the Indian price is expected to be between 35 to 40,000. But if it comes down for anything less than that, this is going to be a pick. The game I'm playing right now is one that has destroyed all worldwide sales records by raking in over $550 million on the first day. The game is Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, and we're going to go and play it right now. So lock and load.
The original Modern Warfare had moved away from the traditional World War II centric settings, opening up new possibilities with stories and weaponry. Modern Warfare 2 continues in that vein and, simply put, makes almost everything just incredibly better than the first one. Beyond the basic improvements to graphics and sound, the gameplay is enhanced with frantic action-packed sequences such as the snowmobile chase.
In the middle.
Hans Zimmer's soundtrack is brilliantly timed to coincide with the most epic events in the game, increasing the overall cinematic feel.
The single-player story mode ends a little too fast, but that's not the end of the game. There's another mode with cooperative multiplayer called Spec Ops.
Spec Ops is a cooperative two-player focused series of challenges. It puts you in separate scenes that don't figure in the main story. The third act is, of course, the online multiplayer mode, which fixes some of the glitches in the first game and introduces new features such as the kill streak. Get 25 kills in a streak and you can access a nuke that'll decimate everyone in the level, leaving you the last man standing.
When the nuke goes off and you're not the one who's fired it, trust me, be someplace else. Anyway, I'm just going to say one thing. If you like shooters and if you like war games, Modern Warfare 2 is the game to pick. We'll take a little break now, but before we do that, you go take a look at this video of this iPhone app that lets you blow out your birthday candles.